My dear students, good morning to all of you. Today I am going to teach you more about pronouns. Yesterday we have studied till one pronoun and today we shall study second pronoun, which is possessive pronoun. What is possessive pronouns? These pronouns which are used to show possession are called possessive pronoun. For example, this pen is mine, those books are yours, this house is ours. It means in the underlined words which are showing on the screen of your mobile, these are called the possessive pronoun. They are mine, yours and ours. After this we shall study the third pronoun, which is reflexive pronoun. The definition: if the possessive pronoun shows the effect of action done by subject on itself, then the pronoun will be called reflexive pronoun. For example, he did it himself, they saw themselves, I visited him myself, etc. You are watching the underlined words which are himself, themselves and myself. These are reflexive pronouns. Now we shall study about the fourth pronoun, which is emphatic pronoun. The definition: when a compound personal pronoun is used for the sake of emphasis, it is called emphatic pronoun. For example, I myself saw him to do it. You yourself can explain it. He himself said so. You are watching on your screen the underlying words: myself, yourself, himself. These words are expressing or emphasizing on its subject, which are I, you, he respectively, and these are emphatic pronoun. After that we shall go for the fifth pronoun, which is demonstrative pronoun. The definition of demonstrative pronoun: demonstrative pronoun is one that indicates the person or thing referred to. For example, this is my book, that is his pencil, these are your books, those are her dolls. In these sentences we are watching that this, that, this, those are indicating respectively book, pencil, books and dolls. Therefore they are demonstrative pronoun. After studying the demonstrative pronoun, we shall now learn the next pronoun, which is as follows. This is the indefinite pronoun. If a pronoun refers to the person or thing in a general way and not in a special way, that is called indefinite pronoun. For example, Nobody came to see me. Do good to others. Both have won prizes. All are well, etc. You are watching some underlined words. In these words are nobody, others, all, and they are indefinite pronouns. After studying this, I am going to give you a few questions which are as follows. You must try to answer all these questions in your notebook and show it to me. Thank you.